novel. He's written three books. One's called Zone, another one's called Kiev 86, and a new one is called Feral Scrap. And I'm going to read you this, and I think you'll see why I'm so excited to be next to him. And he clearly is excited to be here, taking pictures as we go. For me, the zone, and that's what they call this area of Chernobyl, the exclusion zone, or just the zone. For me, the zone is a place of relaxation. Instead of the sea, the Carpathian Mountains, mine waste hills. Instead of Turkey, peppered with tan whores and drought and chilled mojitos. Some 20 times a year, I, an illegal tourist to the Chernobyl zone, a stalker, a pedestrian, a self-propelled vehicle, an idiot, call me what you want. I am not visible, but I am. I exist, almost like ionized radiation. What does it look like? I get my backpack ready, arrive at the barbed wire, and dissolve into the darkness of the policia forests, woodlands, and pine aromas, disappear among the dizziness of thickets, and no one anywhere in the world will notice me. This is about stalkers, not those who collect children's gas masks across the bomb shelters of district cities, and not those who photograph unfinished, pissed-on buildings in residential areas. It's about others, about boys and girls who are not ashamed of putting backpacks on their backs and treading through cold rain to abandoned towns and villages where you can drink cheap vodka, break windows with empty bottles, swear too loud, and do other things which differentiate living towns from dead ones. It's about those who are not afraid of radiation and don't care about drinking from poisonous streams and lakes. My last week has been a road through darkness, the anxious anticipation of light coming from headlights and cigarettes. Then I hoped for a bed without a mattress and icy water from the frozen river. There was coldness and quenching of thirst. There was a patrol that I noticed at the last moment. There was grass, limp, dry, and yellow. And then only a dead dream, so in the morning to run further to the north, to dive into fantasies, into a captivating land of abandoned homes, canals, and agricultural infrastructures.